Ever wondered how video games, websites, and apps are built? Curious about how developers manage complex software projects with ease? It all starts with object-oriented programming. Welcome to Whiteboard Doodles, the channel where we simplify tech-related concepts using whiteboard animations. In today's video, we'll break down the basics of object-oriented programming. By the end, you'll have a solid understanding of OOP principles and how to apply them in your projects. Let's dive in. First, let's briefly take a look at what OOP is. Object-oriented programming, or OOP, is a way of organizing code by using objects to represent real-world things like a car or a person. These objects are created from classes which are blueprints that define what the objects can do and what information they can hold. OOP makes it easier to build and manage complex software by breaking it down into smaller reusable pieces. You can think of it as a special way of writing and organizing code that allows for more structure and makes coding a lot easier. Now that we know what OOP is, let's go through its key concepts. We'll start with the basics such as classes and objects. Then we'll look at attributes and methods, and after that we'll explore more advanced concepts like encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, and abstraction. So let's get started. First, we have classes and objects. Classes and objects are core components of object-oriented programming. A class serves as a blueprint or template for creating objects. It defines the properties and behaviors that the objects created from it will have. An object is an instance of a class. It's a specific example that has the attributes and can perform the actions defined by the class. For example, you might have a class called car that outlines characteristics like color and make, and actions like start and stop. Each individual car you create from this class, like a red Toyota or a blue Honda, is an object. By defining classes, you can create multiple objects with similar structure but different values for their properties. Next, we have attributes and methods. Attributes and methods are another key components of a class in object-oriented programming. Attributes, also known as properties or fields, define the characteristics or data of a class. For example, in a car class, attributes might include color, make, and model. Methods, on the other hand, define the behaviors or functions that a class can perform. These are actions that objects created from the class can execute, such as start, stop, and accelerate. Together, attributes and methods describe the state and behavior of objects, enabling them to model real-world entities and interactions within a program. By combining attributes and methods, classes provide a comprehensive framework for creating objects that encapsulate both data and functionality. Moving on to a more complex but crucial concept, encapsulation. Encapsulation in OOP is like storing items in a treasure chest with a lock. Imagine a treasure chest as a class in programming. Inside the chest are valuable items, attributes, and tools to handle them, methods. The lock on the chest represents encapsulation. It protects the items inside, allowing access only through designated keys or methods. This means that other parts of the program can interact with the chest class only in predefined ways, ensuring security and preventing accidental changes to the items inside. Encapsulation helps organize code neatly, making it easier to maintain and modify without affecting other parts of the program, just like how a locked chest keeps its contents safe and organized. Up next, we have inheritance. Inheritance is a powerful concept that allows one class to inherit the properties and methods of another class. It establishes a hierarchical relationship between classes where one class, called the child or subclass, can inherit behaviors and characteristics from another class, called the parent or superclass. This means that the child class can reuse code from the parent class, reducing redundancy and promoting code reusability. For example, a vehicle class may have attributes and methods common to all vehicles, such as speed and movement. From this superclass, more specific classes like car and motorcycle can inherit these attributes and methods while adding their own unique features like number of doors or two-wheel drive. Inheritance facilitates the creation of a well-organized and modular codebase, allowing developers to build upon existing classes to create new ones with specialized behaviors and characteristics. Now let's discuss polymorphism. Polymorphism is another concept that allows objects of different classes to be treated as objects of a common superclass. It means many forms, and enables a single function or method to operate on different types of objects, making the code more flexible and reusable. For instance, consider a superclass Animal with a method MakeSound. Different subclasses like Dog and Cat can each implement this method uniquely. Dog might return a bark sound, while Cat might return a meow sound. Polymorphism allows you to call MakeSound on any animal object, and the appropriate method for that specific object type will be executed. This simplifies code management and enhances the ability to extend the codebase with new functionality without modifying existing code. And lastly, let's take a look at abstraction. Abstraction is a key idea in OOP that helps simplify complex systems by showing only the important parts and hiding the unnecessary details. Think of it like a TV remote. You only see the buttons to change the channel or volume, not the complex electronics inside. In coding, abstraction allows developers to create simple models of real-world things. For example, a vehicle class might define general features all vehicles have, like wheels and the ability to move. Specific types like car or bicycle can then use this general model, but add their own unique features. This makes the code easier to understand and manage, letting developers focus on the big picture without getting lost in the details. In conclusion, object-oriented programming stands as a powerful paradigm that enhances software development in numerous ways. By organizing code into modular units that encapsulate data and behavior, OOP promotes code reusability, flexibility, and scalability. This approach fosters cleaner, more maintainable codebases, which are crucial for large-scale projects and collaborative development environments. Moreover, OOP aligns well with real-world modeling, making it easier to conceptualize and implement complex systems. Its principles such as encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, and abstraction enable developers to design robust solutions that evolve with changing requirements. Embracing OOP not only improves productivity, but also lays a foundation for building sophisticated applications that meet modern software engineering standards. This marks the end of our exploration of the basics of object-oriented programming. If you enjoyed it, consider subscribing to our channel and liking the video. Feel free to also check out our other videos on related topics. Thank you for watching.